Hi, Wee Bob here. And have you ever wanted to know if watercolour painting can be done on a computer in the digital world? Is it possible? Today is the 21st of October 2022. Rebelle 5 Pro can be purchased for $10. It has went mental the past few weeks and it's great. So I'm hoping that you're going to see this video. I'm hoping you're going to pick up for $10. And there's a link in the description which I would get a small commission for if you use, but I'm not bothered. Just go get Rebelle 5. It's a fantastic program. This video is moving on to look more in depth at the watercolour capabilities of Rebelle 5 Pro. Me personally, I have been doing digital art and 3D modelling for over 20 years now and really focusing on digital art for about the past 6 years. Getting right into this, we have our usual paper selection screen, and this is important when it comes to watercolour as it will determine some of the effects that you will get when using the watercolour feature, the simulation. I have chosen this paper set. Now, why does your paper selection matter? And it is because of what is known in Rebelle 5 as the visual settings. The visual settings menu can be found under the window menu and then visual settings. We can see the visual settings menu appear. If you cannot see it and you're using multiple screens as I do, it may be on another screen, or the menu may be collapsed and you need to expand it using the expand panel button as shown. Quite a few times I have struggled to find the pop-up menus that feature in Rebelle 5 because they've been on another screen, and when they're collapsed they are quite small, so just keep looking for it if you can't find it. We're using watercolour in this video, so I will collapse the oils and acrylic control sliders, we don't need them. Nanopixel is a Rebelle 5 Pro feature, and if you don't have Rebelle 5 Pro you might not see this, and it removes pixelation from your artwork when zoomed in. With it, we are able to export our artwork up to 16 times larger in size. This will help if you're looking at doing large prints for people. Be aware though that the ability to export at the larger size is dependent on your computer being able to support that feature. Mine's didn't previously, I've recently upgraded my graphics card. The paper we select will give a preset of values to these sliders. We can change these at any time during the drawing process, which is a great feature, especially when trying to get different effects, which we will get onto a bit later in this video. I have chosen an A4 size, and on my Huion Canvas Pro 22, I can set my screen to approximately A4 size as shown. This is important as in digital art, unlike real life paper, we can zoom in too far and concentrate on details that no one will ever see at the size we intend on printing at. For those that may not have a pressure sensitive pen device and may be using a mouse, we can bring up an additional slider called the pressure slider. This allows you to adjust the pressure of the brush to the canvas. The watercolour painting we are about to do is loosely based on another YouTuber's traditional art version. I've put their name on the screen and linked to their video in the description. The main reason for watching a traditional art video was to try and mimic their process and see if doing so would give similar results. In Rebelle 5, we have the ability to set a mixing palette to the side. Now I personally don't like using this and I prefer to mix my colours on the canvas, but I used it in this example to again try and mimic what we would be doing with real life watercolours. It can be accessed again through the window menu and then docked into our menus at the side as shown. The first step that we do is to wet the full canvas using the icon and menu as shown, choosing wet the layer. To make sure you have access to the watercolour palette, it can be accessed through the colour palette menu on the right, as shown. Some of the more advanced features of the colour palette were discussed in that previous video I mentioned earlier, so you will want to check that out after maybe watching this video for further tips. In the colour palette, we can pick our colours and mix them. In this example, we are taking a red and yellow to get a fiery orange sky colour. We can then choose the watercolour brush icon at the top left and choose our specific brushes. Please know that some of the brushes I have don't exist by default as I have created them myself. For this painting though, I have used a basic round brush to get started. With our paper set to being wet and our brush water level about quarter, we get some watercolour effect happening as we paint, but it is not out of control and it lets us lay down the colours where we want them. The water simulation stops every time you touch the paper because of all the mathematics that goes into trying to mimic water. If we want more of a dry brush effect, we need to turn the water on the brush down using the slider on the left. Note that to get some of the textures, I find that doing quick strokes with the water level low seems to work better. There is some more advanced features which I'll get into in another video. If this video has been of use to you so far, please consider hitting the subscribe button, especially if you want to see those other videos. If you could hit the like button, it massively helps my channel and I really appreciate it. Using the blending tool for the watercolour can sometimes be bad, as it takes away the watercolour effect or the look of our drawings, so you just need to be careful when using it. So in this example, I have used it to try and obtain a smooth transition between the colours added. During this tutorial, we're going to briefly jump over to look at some of the tools in Rebelle 5. Let's talk about the icon down here, which gives us watercolour options for transparent, semi-transparent and opaque. I have coloured these little test points quickly and paused the video here. The top row of colour samples is at a lower opacity or a lower amount of paint on our brush, and it's quite difficult to see any real difference between them. When we look at the bottom row, there is a bit of difference, but again, it is quite subtle. So, should we concern ourselves with this icon? And my answer is kind of yes and no. So if I continue the video, what you will see is that when you set this icon to transparent and we keep adding colour, the colour actually burns. It burns to black. It just keeps, it's like if you've ever had the see-through paper that's kind of plasticky and it's a particular colour, the more layers that you put of that on top of each other, it almost goes to black. Whereas if you look at the other two, the semi-transparent and the opaque, when you just keep adding colour to these, they stay the same colour. They don't go to that black colour, which is personally what I prefer. I normally keep it at semi-transparent and a change to opaque if I'm trying to get a solid colour down on the canvas without any real mixing happening. Let's turn our attention to your paper size and watercolour simulation for a minute or two. Depending on your computer specification, the water simulation will be affected. Normally I work previous other digital art programs, from Photoshop to Sketchbook to Clip Studio to Krita, all of which I've used. I would normally use 4K and about 300 dpi. But when I tried to use that in Rebelle 5, it's just a big no-no because my computer's just a bit older and it's not up to the task. So personally, I would test out different sizes and DPI to determine what your computer can handle, so that you don't get frustrated, because I found this very frustrating when first using Rebelle. Like, where's the water simulation? Why is it not happening? Why is it so laggy? For me, working at A4 but bringing the DPI lower allows the simulation to work really well with the computer that I've got. Now, going quickly through the different brush tools that we have, from Paint, Paint and Mix, Paint and Blend, to Blender and Eraser, we can see the differences that we get. Again, they're subtle. If there's a specific colour we want in the canvas, then we just want to be painting. For the most part, I tend to use Paint and Blend and try not to get too concerned with changing these until I need a particular look to my painting. As with the previous icon, the opacity or the amount of paint on the canvas will affect the results we get with these tools, as does the pressure. So the pressure that you've got in your pen affects the blend that takes place. And it's just really practicing and seeing what's working and what's not. We'll talk about more tools a wee bit later in this video, but getting back to our dragons and sunset drawing, we're mixing some dark grey and blue for the sky and the sea. At this point, it looks like I'm trying to do some kind of weird Harry Potter spell, but I'm actually just trying to wet the full paper to see if I can get the colours to run together better. I add some real dark blue grey areas for waves and then blend them out. Again, just be careful using the blender. As you can see, we're adding some dark clouds at this point, but notice that the water slider is all the way up, and if you watch, you will see this adds almost like a water wall effect. Not something that looks particularly pretty, it looks like something you would see in a petri dish. We might want this, but for this drawing it's not what we're going for. We can either undo, or in this example I decided to blend out the colours to make it more what I was looking for, and it gives us some extra depth. It gives some added colour rather than just undoing. That's where we get some of these nice things that just happen. They happen by chance. At this point, we're starting to get to the point where our background wash colours are where we want them to be. And we want them to stay that way. And we can dry the layer at this point using the icon and selecting from the menu, dry the layer. I'm now going to take you back to talking about tools. Of all the things in Rebelle 5 for watercolour, I would say this is one of the most important set of controls we have available to us. To demonstrate this, I have laid down two very wet with very high level of paint, a red and a yellow colour. When we turn on the water layer, we can see the simulation taking place. We can add more water using the droplet icon, or we can dry it using the drying icon. As I mentioned previously, we can choose presets, and in this case we have chosen cold pressed. We have the create drips selection box on, and our tilt is fully down at full strength. Now if you look at the diffusion speed, this literally is just how fast the water simulation will take place, and it will be restricted only by your computer speed. Therefore, if you have lag when changing this slider, you should consider a smaller canvas with a lower DPI. Please make sure you have a look at the recommended computer specification the Escape Motions have suggested, and see the description of this video, as I've put some of that information in there. With the diffusion speed set low, the simulation is creeping. With it set to high, it acts more like real watercolour would. We can pause the simulation at any point and dry the layer if we have got an effect that we like. The absorbency slider is just like it indicates. It is how fast the water is absorbed by the paper. The higher the value, the water is absorbed quicker, so on and so forth. We then want to consider how wet areas and dry areas interact. When an area is wet, it should only be those areas which are affected by the simulation, as shown, as it would in real life as well. If we add drips, this will carry water over the canvas to other areas. It'll act like a connecting river for the paint to follow. The next slider we want to consider is rewet, and I think this is one of the most important sliders that this program has. If I set rewet to zero, the paint that is already on the canvas is not affected. If I increase the rewet slider, the paint that is already on the canvas and may have previously been dried will be rewetted, if that's a word, and picked up as part of the simulation. If we have it all the way up to the highest value, it picks up all the paint and we then just left with the white of our canvas behind it. And when we put it to a mid value, it picks up some of the paint that was previously put down on the canvas, but not all of it. The last slider is a texture influence slider, and this is where we see how much the paper that we have chosen affects the paint as shown. So a low number and the texture of the paper has no real effect, it's very smooth. A high value and the paper texture shows through. So now that we have seen these techniques, let's return to our dragon drawing where we'll apply some of them. We then can start to add in those bolder colours with darker values. As you can see, when you're looking at fluid shapes that are not boats or solid structures, we can experiment with the amount of water on our brush. Note that at this point we have two layers. The only reason for the other layer is it acts almost like a save point for me. As I go along, if I get to a stage where I'm like, okay, I like that, I don't want to mess up, I will make a new layer and then just hide the previous layer. Just be careful because sometimes that can slow down your computer if you've got too many layers. Notice how we are adding highlights to our objects by thinking about where the sun would be shining and hitting these boats. This also applies to the waves. We've used some of the textured brushes with no water to add the sparkling effects near the horizon. This was a powder pencil under the pencil set. As we are adding these bold objects, the use of the pencils or inking pens is what we would normally do in traditional art. Anyway, gel pens for highlights, for example. As this is a dragon drawing using some of the techniques we discussed earlier in this video, we can get some of these great effects just by adding water to the canvas. In this case, using the methods we discussed in the previous videos on dragons, we can outline the shape just using water. Note that while doing this, we are drying the paper multiple times to stop the water simulation at specific points. This is one of the great advantages of digital art, that the control and capability to just undo the things that we don't like. It can also be a curse though, so use it sparingly, and as my namesake would say, sometimes the happy little accidents are what makes our drawings that bit more special. If you want to see more tutorials based on Rebelle 5, you will want to check out the playlist in the corner, all of the Rebelle 5 videos I have done. Thanks for watching, and Weebob is out.